welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are staying safe and doing well. And in today's video, we will be talking about menstrual cups. This is like the latest thing in the period world. Everybody has been talking about it, but at the same time, not a lot of people opt for it. It may be due to lack of awareness, fear, could be anything. Hence, let's go ahead and see if we can eradicate some of that fear and shed light on menstrual cups, if it's really a very good option, how to use it, what if it gets stuck, does it hurt, is it disgusting, can we change it in a public restroom, and lastly, can it cause a tear to your hymen? Let's find out. As opposed to tampons or sanitary pads, this silicone menstrual cup collects the blood instead of soaking it. It looks like this, with a stem, and some good cups have holes at the rim to ease the vacuum during cup removal. We'll get into that in a bit. I'm using the one by Carmacy. For a beginner like me, this is a great option. Now let's get to the part about using it, and I'll pitch in my experience as well. The first step before using it is to sterilize it in boiling water for 5 to 7 minutes. Cleanse your hands as well and only then take the cup out. You will need to fold the cup in order to easily insert it since the rim is very large. Now there are 3 ways you can fold in order to do that. Now there's the C technique or the U technique where you just push the rim to the other side and fold it forming a C or a U shape, hence the name. This is the most simple one, but it did not quite work for me since it just kept popping open, but there are other 2 folds. Second would be the punch down technique, where using your thumb you push the rim down forming a very narrow entry point. This one actually worked quite well for me. And then there's the 7-shape technique, where you bring the rim together, fold the top and bring it to the bottom forming a 7-shape. These were the 3 ways on how you can fold your menstrual cup. Now coming to the point of how to place it. It should be either in a squatting position, sitting on the commode is the most convenient, or if you want to stand, you can raise one leg onto a table and this position would be fine too. Most importantly, don't panic. It's completely normal to be anxious your first time. Just relax, take a deep breath, fold it according to your convenience and be in the right position. In fact, try all 3 folds the first time to see which one suits you better. Use your left hand to open up your labia and use your right hand to insert the cup all the way in. Like really try placing it in all in the first go. Now, how do you know that you've placed it correctly? For one, you shouldn't even be able to feel the cup. It should be that comfortable. But what if the stem is out? Well, the stem is adjustable according to the location of your cervix. If you've placed it correctly and only the stem is out, you can always cut the stem according to your convenience. It will not affect the cup. You anyways do not use the stem to pull the menstrual cup out. You only use the stem to locate where the menstrual cup is. Also, there is one tiny bit of detail. You need to check if the menstrual cup has fully opened. Since sometimes it doesn't fully open up and you can have a little bit of a leakage. So once the cup has been placed, you need to pinch the bottom of the cup and slightly rotate it in order to check if it's fully placed. A simple test to check if it's perfectly placed and fully open is to try pulling it out, since the cup goes all the way up there and forms a vacuum, making it hard for it to leave the place, hence locking the cup in place. So if you're trying to pull and there is a bit of resistance, that means it's perfectly placed and it's ready to be used. Sounds a bit complicated, right? The first 2 times when you have to insert and pull it out, it can be a bit tough, but please be patient, it's very normal. I myself was extremely annoyed and frustrated the first time because it just kept popping out. That's because a lot of us use pads, so it's a little difficult to get started with menstrual cups since we're not used to jamming something up there, especially during our periods. Unless, of course, you've used tampons before. Now, can it get messy? Since it's your first time, absolutely, because you're going to take at least 2 to 3 tries before you can place the cup in. Be prepared to get your hands bloody. I can't believe I just said that on camera, But there's no point sugarcoating it. It is what it is. But once you get the hang of it, it becomes much easier and you can do it in a minute or so. Now, what if you have to change this in a public restroom? It is the worst thing ever. Please try to avoid it at any circumstance since the cup lasts for up to 8 hours. So time it correctly. But if there's an emergency, then try to find a restroom which has a jet spray or at least a tap. Because otherwise you'll have to wash it in the common sink in front of everybody while placing a piece of toilet paper to catch the leak. I'm speaking from experience, it is not good. So these days I always have panty liners in my bag just in case, and also don't forget to keep the cloth bag just in case. We are not done yet. Now at the end of the day, you still have to remove it and you need to know how to do that exactly. First things first, you do not use the stem to pull it out. The stem is only used to locate the cup. To remove it, and this is very important, you have to pinch the bottom of the cup to break the vacuum and then slowly pull it out. And don't worry, you will not lose the cup in there. It will not travel to your abdomen. It's not physically possible. So do not worry about it. Once you've taken it out, drain it, wash it, and you can use it again. Once your cycle is over, you will have to again boil it for 5 to 7 minutes and store it in a cloth bag, which usually comes along with the menstrual cup. But remember to boil it again when your next cycle starts the following month. After listening to all this, I'm sure a lot of you must be like, is it even worth a try? Oh yes. The hard part is only the inserting and the removal. But once it's up there, nothing like it. You can dance, you can swim, you can do any physical activity for up to 6 to 8 hours. Even if it's your second day, you can wear it just before you leave for work or college and come back home and only then replace it. It lasts all day, and if you wear it before going to bed, it lasts all night too. You don't have to wake up early in the morning to change, worry about it shifting, staining your bed sheet, sleeping uncomfortably on one side, none of it. If worn correctly, it's the best thing ever. You'll even forget that you have periods for at least 6 to 8 hours. Plus, there's no odor since it doesn't come in contact with outside air, no rashes, economical since a good quality menstrual cup can cost you somewhere around 500 and last up to 3 to 5 years. And lastly, it's good for the environment. It's a sustainable choice. Now, coming to a very important question, can teenagers use it? Well, yes, it comes in 3 different sizes. The smallest one is for sexually inactive girls, medium is for women who haven't given birth vaginally, and large is for women who have given birth vaginally. But can a hymen break if you use menstrual cup? It's both yes and no. Some girls have a very thin hymen and some have a thicker one comparatively. So it's definitely possible for it to break if you have a very thin layer of hymen. But hymen could also break at any given time when you're doing some rigorous exercise, cycling, or if you're an athlete. And most importantly, it should not be considered as a sign of virginity. While we are on this subject, it is 100% okay to not bleed your first time. It doesn't mean anything. A lot of women don't. In fact, this might be TMI, but I didn't either my first time. I might get in trouble with my family for saying this, but I know for a fact that none of them watch my videos till the very end. So don't fret, don't go crazy, get all panicky. It's very normal, very common. Getting back to the topic, it's up to you if you want to use a menstrual cup as a teenager. Please discuss it with your mom and then decide. And with that, we've come to the end of this video. A big thanks to Carmacy for partnering with us on today's video. They have a wide range of products when it comes to periods, like menstrual cups, tampons, sanitary napkins, and many more. You've already seen me talk about menstrual cups. Their tampons are also easy to use, made with 100% organic cotton, available in three different sizes: regular for medium flow, super plus for extra heavy flow, and super for heavy flow. Carmesi has two different menstrual sanitary pads. One is Carmesi Sensitive Pads, which is the first pad to be a certified 100% rash-free pad. If you face a lot of rashes and are afraid to shift to menstrual cups or tampons, then this is one of the best options. The other pad is the Eco-Conscious Pad, which is plant-based composition, also rash-free. This pad is not only safe for the body, but also for the planet. Carmesi at the moment has a huge women's sale going on, and you can also use my coupon code to avail additional discounts. I'll drop the link in the description box below. Do try out their products and let me know in the comment section. As always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment below. I'll see you soon. Bye!